this video will be an example of how to use Maxwell relations whenever we have a partial derivative show up that we don't necessarily know, but we can use it through Maxwell relations to substitute for a simpler one which we do know for our given system. Okay, so our challenge here is to find the entropy change of a reversible isothermal expansion of an ideal gas. So we've done this derivation earlier, but now we have a different way of going about that derivation. So the entropy change that occurs during some expansion or compression event of an ideal gas is going to be the entropy of the final state minus the entropy of the initial state. So that's entropy is a state function. It doesn't matter how we got from point A to point B, it just matters what they are. So this is an integral from the initial state to the final state of the entropy that occurs during every point in the path along the way, which is equal to the integral from the initial to final state of the partial derivative of the entropy with respect to volume at constant temperature, since it's isothermal, integrated with respect to volume. So right now we don't know dSdV. Maybe we have no way of getting what that is. But there's a Maxwell relation that if we look on the previous video, which summarizes those relationships, where we see dSdV at constant T, which I believe is the relation from the Helmholtz energy, that's equal to the partial derivative of the pressure with respect to temperature at constant volume. So for an ideal gas, it obeys the ideal gas law, PV equals nRT. So the pressure of an ideal gas equals nRT over V. So the partial derivative of the pressure of an ideal gas with respect to temperature at constant volume is going to be ddT of nRT over V, which is going to be number of moles of gas times gas constant divided by volume of the system. All right, so now delta S equals the integral of, since we're integrating over volume, our initial to final state is the initial volume to the final volume, of our integral now, or our derivative is nR over V. So we have nR over V times dV. We can factor out nR as a constant. Integral of dV over V is natural log of V. Natural log of V final minus natural log of V initial gives us the ratio of those two volumes. So the entropy change during a process of the expansion or compression of an ideal gas is equal to number of moles times gas constant times natural log of the final over the initial volume. And that's a relationship which we were able to use due to the Maxwell relation that came from the Helmholtz free energy.